Not only have Astralis shown us incredible grenade stacks, they've completely shifted the meta, even around individual utility usage.
Don't know how to build a team from scratch or find good teammates? DreamTeam.gg, the ultimate team building platform. Find and connect with new players, coaches and teams. Manage and monetize your team. Get on fast track to advance from novice to amateur and, if desired, to professional gamer. Join DreamTeam.gg today.
So let's start with those pre-planned nade stacks. Obviously, I just showed you one in the intro, and that's the first one we're concentrating on. There's a whole different way to use these. Obviously, we saw a few of them in an earlier video. I'll probably link that in the description somewhere. So there's a couple in that one, particularly Overpass, which we won't be covering today, so I've got a video on that. But we're going to be focusing on this particular nade stack on Inferno, at least to start off with. I'm going to talk about the different times you can use it. So obviously, in this one right now, they take out Nico. You guys all saw that. The nade's going to come through from Device and Glaive, and it's a very standard stack. Right into this corner where an AWP is often holding from, or in this scenario, as you can see from Magic's point of view, they did throw two Molotovs down, obviously trying to attempt some deep banana control, and they are just holding this angle in the meantime, just in case Astralis maybe smoke off that top banana molly, try and rush through. You can still get some good angling just in case that happens. They're actually attempting deep banana control, trying to set something up in this scenario. So if you suspect that's coming in, which it normally is from the CT side, it's a great time every now and then just to throw in this nade stack, potentially get yourself an opener into a round. We haven't actually seen Astralis use the nade stack in this way, but when I first saw this, I thought about potentially punishing a solo AWPer left here at the B site. You can see in this scenario, they've left Device, trusted him here, to lock down Banana, and this is very common. Get an AWPer up here, they try and get the first pick off, or if they're flashed away, they normally just shoot a shot, fall back to the next corner. And when they get to this next corner is exactly the point I thought you could maybe punish these AWPers, because what they usually do is they fall back to this corner, as Device does right now, and they don't normally move back any further until they get some point of contact. And you notice as well, right here, Device actually has a Molotov, so what they normally do is wait for this point of contact, this wall, get their shot off, and then drop the Molotov at their feet as they run back to site, giving the rotator more time to come into the site. Obviously, Zipex is already there in this scenario. But normally, that Molotov just buys that extra bit of time for him to rotate back onto this B site if he is required. But my thought process was, what if after this first flash here, you just stop for a second? We've seen they set up really quickly with Molotovs burning at their feet in that previous round. Just throw both the nades from here right into this corner where Device is holding from right now. Potentially just take that AWP around. That's going to force the rotate no matter what. Zipex is going to come over here. You're going to have a man advantage straight away. And you can see exactly what happens here. Device takes the shot, drops the Molotovs as we said. But if you just go quiet in Banana after that first initial flash, double nade that corner, you can potentially find yourself an opening kill. And yeah, just an easy entry into the round. Another little detail I've noticed with Astralis is when taking this top banana control, is often teams obviously Molotov it off to try and stop anyone peeking that car position, trying to get an opening kill with an AWP or such. But often we see players such as Guardian just ignore this, take the 50 points of damage, hoping for the opening kill. One thing they actually include is Glaive will also nade at this top car position. So if someone does try to peek, they're going to get caught in that nade, stuck in the Molotov, and then almost certainly die rather than just getting away with 50 points of health lost. Astralis also have another great attempt over here at T-side Banana to try and get themselves a second opening when forcing the T's back from this top banana control, the car position. You see, Device gets the opening onto Nico, and he continues pushing up into this banana area. And notice right now Kerrigan's position. So if Device is already up here at Banana, he's gone relatively fast. I just want you to remember where Kerrigan is right now. He's right here at these blue barrels, just throwing his smoke. So the timing's a little bit off for Astralis in this one. This is the first time I saw them attempt this, but I like the idea to try and completely open up the B site. And again, it's just another fun way to use these grenades. You see, they've really thought it out. So what basically happens is Kerrigan's moved back to new box now, but you can see they threw these grenades when Kerrigan was trying to smoke off Banana, the position where players often do smoke it off from. He could definitely have been caught off guard there, and that would have been no one left on the B site, and essentially the round over for FaZe. The other nade stack we saw from Astralis was obviously on Dust 2 onto the player at top middle. And they've basically worked out the timing of how teams normally take mid control on the T side, how it normally works. You'll see in a second, but the player comes under, the player top mid flushes him out so that no one can be boosting up here trying to peek into middle or just trying to get a peek down generally. See Devices up here quite fast. He could potentially peek onto Elise right now. So notice Twist is holding quite passive. He comes out here to start to throw his flash, as I said, because a player such as Device could potentially be peeking down to unders, or a player at the box maybe snuck out trying to get an AWP kill onto the player here. So you flash so that he can peek quite comfortably in unders, and then you just take middle together with this guy coming like so. You come and clear out catwalk, and then you just take that very standard mid control. That's just how the map works, always has to. So they've worked out, obviously, Astralis, that this is the timing of when this happens. So as Twist tries to come out to throw his flash, two nades greet him at the top of middle, and he's down to 15 points of health. Actually lucky to get away with his life. And this isn't the only time they use it. They use it again in round 14. A couple of seconds earlier this time, because notice the Xbox smoke comes in. So they've obviously thought about it. I think if this Xbox smoke comes in, we'll throw it a little bit earlier. You can see, actually it's a little bit too early in this one. Twist maybe learnt. He only takes 50 points of health. But again, just showing that Snack is very viable, and definitely you'll take that damage early into a round. Another thing Astralis seem to have become quite good at is nading the player planning the bomb. When the CT suddenly get locked out of a site, such as they have done on the B site here, you're going to see Zipex just do a great lot of damage with his grenade into this bomb planner behind the box, and he's just going to take him out quite simply. You might think, well, maybe he just used the sound cues to hear Taco there, that's not really that impressive. But what if we look about what Device did at the exact same time? Well, Device threw this Molotov. You might be thinking, okay, that's a nice little Molotov. But if we look at the site right now, you can see exactly what this has done. Zipex takes out Taco, but look what this Molotov spreads to. It covers the whole default plant position. So if we look at the map right now, maybe you can argue that Molotov was a little bit late from Device. But you think about it, if you Molotov off the default, Molotov off this area, where's the next most likely spot for these players to plant? It's behind this box right here. That's the other, I'd say, second default. If you've watched any versions of Dust 2, you probably know that's the second most likely spot for players to plant. So basically, Zipex deals with this plant position, which happened to be the one in this scenario, so he takes out Taco relatively quickly with his grenade slash spam combo. And then Device Molotovs off the planter. So either the plant goes down and this player takes a heap of damage, which probably would have been the situation in this scenario since the Molotov was a little bit late. But they're dealing damage no matter what goes on here. They're dealing damage to the bomb planter. They've got a 3v2. They're making their retake just a little bit easier. And it's just an incredible use of utility and one that we haven't really seen used before. If you don't know how to throw that Molotov, it's pretty simple. Just back yourself into this wall. Basically get yourself so this black marking is out the right of this wall here, so you're not going to hit that on your throw, so you're going to back yourself up about like so. If you want a hard lineup, I guess you could line up the door with the box like so, but again, you want to be fast like Device, so you just want to back yourself away, just aim just under that black dot. You're going to bounce off like so. You're going to see this beautifully cover off the default area. It actually spread out really nicely and cover quite a lot of the B site. Now to get to this point, obviously Astralis are very disciplined with their nades. They don't often throw these grenades or Molotovs unless there's a reason to, unless some contact comes out from the T side. You can see Zipex gets the inkling they're coming up short, so his Molotov goes off straight away, but he still got his HE grenade here. And again, he doesn't throw it just hoping that maybe he'll catch someone crossing the site. He waits till he hears the bomb plant come down, tosses it in, and just finishes off two players really nicely. And this is a general theme throughout a lot of the different maps. We see them play the exact same thing here on Mirage in the CT side. He just plays the CT area. He knows they've got the pick towards connect. They're probably going to hold that area. Plant front of triple. Just gets the nade in really simply. And the only reason he can do this is because they're so disciplined. They're not throwing their grenades away early round. They're not just like praying that they're going to throw a grenade, drop it somewhere. There's someone going to be there. It's either some kind of pre-nade at the start of a round, maybe to try and deter some kind of push from the T side. Or they get some information. You see exactly the same in this one with the glaive. He gets the information. They're pushing up short as he's rotating in on Inferno. And the interesting thing about this, if I just pause it right now, is the fact that he prioritizes his grenade over what we might have seen from other players before, such as flashbangs or maybe try and get a Molotov in here to try and delay or split up the push. So they seem to really be pushing this idea of throw the HE grenade first. If we know there's players there, don't worry about delaying them with flashes. Do that damage nice and early just to soften them up and then trust ourselves to hit the shot rather than hitting these flashbangs. Obviously, they're still very important, but there seems to be a little bit of shift towards throwing HEs as soon as you know the player's there rather than a flash to try and deter them from pushing in. Probably the biggest example of this was when this rush came in from Liquid Up Banana. And again, normally when a player gets taken out, you know they're rushing. Often a Molotov comes out. A glaive doesn't have one in this scenario. But again, he chooses to throw a grenade. Often players, as I said, I don't know how many times I've seen players in this exact same situation. Instead of nading and then flashing when they get back onto site, such as glaive is, they'll throw their flash first and then their other utility later. They've switched the order. They've given grenades the priority, it seems. And they're doing a huge amount of damage with it. I can't remember some of the stats. I know one of them was something like 1,000 points of damage at the end of the first half on Dust 2, or something ridiculous like that. Astralis, of course, have a few other ideas. This was the most notable one from the game, where Glaive did a heap of damage, just waiting for this top banana control to come in front of the team. Obviously, one thing to notice is Zipex is watching, so he can't get snuck up on. He's not just standing there with a nade out like some kind of clown. But as soon as this top banana Molotov comes out, I'll probably move around a bit so you can see, as soon as this control comes in, Glaive knows they're about to come up here. Nade comes over, does huge damage onto Twists. This might not seem like a huge deal, but when you're versing 5 CZs, 50 points of health lost on a player and then a couple of HP off NAF can be the difference between 2 kills or just 2 tags with the pistols the way they've been changed. So again, that's a small thing they've done. One other use I saw was they seem to be trying to use like 2 or 3 nades as kind of like a Molotov. It's like a people call them nukes, but they're kind of like, to me, they're like a super Molotov. Obviously, you use a Molotov to clear out a corner. Like, you know, on Dust 2, for example, I want to clear outside. I don't want an AWPer sitting there, potentially AWPing me down from Goose or whatever. What they do is they just throw three grenades in there. So if there's an AWPer there, he's not just running away and being forced off the position. He's going down and the site's completely open. He doesn't even have a chance to reposition. I love this. And I hopefully see more of these. Obviously, I didn't see it succeed too many times. I mean, I've included a clip right now where they haven't got a whole pile of kills. But I love the ideas behind it, and I'm interested to see how it works out in the future. I'll also probably make a video about how to save your utility. Obviously, I talked a little bit about that today, how they have Zipex and such are holding onto their nades and Molotovs until they can use it, such as when the player's planning the bomb. If you want to see that, let me know. I'll probably do it anyway, but let me know. And that's really about it, guys. Make sure to subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll catch you all in the next one.